One of my favorite things about photography is being able to document locations at different times of year. I find it endlessly fascinating how drastically compositions can change with a simple variation in weather and a revived sense of creativity.
I walk down that lonesome lane, hung down my head and cried. I weeped and I cried under a willow tree, and I feel the deep blue sea.
My first example of compositions changing is this blue bus. The last time I shot here in the winter, I decided to shoot the rugged textures of the bus door. The frozen moss and chipping paint made my decision pretty easy at the time, but today, I decided to shoot the inside of the camper. Composing in here proved to be pretty difficult. All right, I'm trying not to move my tripod, so I'm standing in a really strange position. There's a little echo in here. This is a 30-second exposure at f/32 because I can't really see what's in focus, what's not in focus. I don't know if the bottom is completely blurred out, if the top's completely blurred out, but there is a window that I can see towards the back, which is what I'm focusing on. This is a really awkward position to stand, so I'm gonna take my 30-second exposure. f/32. I couldn't see well, but I was able to see and set focus on the very back door of the camper, which at the time was illuminated by the sun. But one area that I wanted to include was the decaying animal corpse in the foreground. As you can see, I got it in the shot, but it's completely out of focus. But boy, oh boy, was that not the biggest issue that I faced today.
That's not the sound I wanted.
I can tell you right now that that shot's gonna be underexposed. I checked my shutter speed, it's supposed to be 1/4 of a second, but when I hit the shutter, it just went click. So just fiddling around with the camera a little bit, I know what just happened. I didn't actually close the shutter all the way. The shutter wasn't open at all, but I didn't close it all the way. And I did a couple of test shots without any film in it. And the shutter wasn't opening at all. It was actually just clicking, but the aperture wasn't opening or anything like that. The shutter wasn't opening. So I've got it fully closed. Now I'm going to take the shot again. Now that sounds more like 1/4 of a second. Might be a double exposure. We'll find out in developing. Just goes to show, even when you feel comfortable with the format, there are always challenging moments. It is a humbling way to tell yourself to slow down. As I mentioned earlier, when you document the same location over time, your compositions change. The Blue Mercury Comet is a good case study in that. It's actually really, really dark inside of the comet, and the shot that I would want to get is the one that I took the last time. I was hoping that the sun would shine through a little bit better, a little bit more, and illuminate that comet sign. I think if I wait maybe another hour, honestly, I think I missed it if it was coming up rather than starting to crest towards 11 in the morning. I think I would have a better shot at this than I do right now. So, hey, you win some, you lose some, but no sense in taking a shot that's gonna be worse than a shot that I already have of this exact angle. So move on and try to find something else to photograph.
Sometimes
things don't go to plan and an audible must be called.
So I think I actually did find an exposure to make out of the comet, and it's on the back half where it says Mercury Comet. And it looks pretty good right now. I'm waiting for just a couple of clouds to pass through to really kind of make that emblem just look real, real nice. But I think I found a good shot. I think I'm gonna take it. I do apologize for the crazy bird noises. The birds have been crazy loud today. I love it, but it makes for a pain to edit.
I really wanted the shadows to be the unsung hero of this image. Let those dark areas get real dark and leave that logo on the trunk to be the brighter focal point. And I think it turned out pretty good. I found this to be my most difficult day of shooting at this location for several reasons. Obviously, the errors that speak more to my unchecked arrogance in regards to shooting issues, but most of all, it was the weather. The 90 degree heat with no clouds is just not my favorite weather to shoot in. I crave rainy days and cooler weather, and there's just something about those conditions that make me feel just a little bit more creative. Either way, I hope you guys really enjoyed this little trip out and enjoyed seeing some of my struggles. I will see you all in the next one. Bye.
Okay, that was, oh, can't forget my polarizing filter. I didn't use it on that shot. No need. You wanna see what it looks like in there? I don't know if you guys can tell or not, but it's pretty hot out and I'm sweating. Being in this hot camper is not making it any easier. Oh yeah, look. My Flying Brian Pillman t-shirt came in. How the heck did that happen? I just texted a picture of the comet to my dad and I said, name this car. And he goes, that's a Mercury. That's a Mercury comet. But the classic car guy always comes through. I think the most ticks I've ever had on me at one time was 12. And when I got home, I didn't realize there were so many. They were on my chest, on my legs, on my stomach. They were everywhere. And there was some in my hair and I panicked and I buzzed my hair because I was freaking out at how many ticks were on me. There were so many. Today I'm gonna be a little bit more calm when I get home and find some ticks. Not gonna shave my head. Shit. Both sides have the white showing. And I took a shot of the interior of the camper with one of these. Mm-hmm.